Hey guys, it's Greg with Apple Explained, and today we're going to talk about the mystery behind Apple's AirPower, because even though it isn't released yet, AirPower's story is already full of twists and turns that are quite unusual for an Apple product. Now, this video came in third place in last week's voting poll, and if you didn't get to vote, make sure you're subscribed. That way, the polls will show up right in your mobile activity feed, and you can let me know which video you'd like to see next. Now, it all began back in September 2017, when Apple announced the iPhone 8, 8 Plus, and 10. These new iPhone models featured wireless charging as a main selling point, so if Apple was ever going to offer a wireless charging mat, they knew it should be announced alongside these new iPhones. Because not only is that simply good marketing, but it would prevent customers from buying third-party charging mats since they'd be waiting on the AirPower's imminent release. And that's exactly what the company did. Apple's Phil Schiller revealed AirPower at the end of the iPhone event, but it was only a sneak peek, which meant no detailed information was provided. Apple didn't share any product specifications, there was no explanation of how exactly the technology worked, and we weren't told how much it would cost. In fact, if you listen to Phil Schiller's words closely, you might get the idea that even Apple wasn't sure how the product would work. For example, Phil started off the AirPower sneak peek by saying,
"Our team wants to create something I think all of us are going to want to use, and it might actually help move the entire industry forward."
Notice he didn't say, "Our team has created something I think all of us are going to want to use." Now, initially, I didn't look too much into this statement until I heard these next two lines. First, he said,
"So we're going to give you a sneak peek of this idea right now."
And lastly, he said,
"This is not possible with current standards. But our team knows how to do this."
But our team knows how to do this, instead of saying, "But our team has done this." So judging by these statements, you could draw a few conclusions. First, maybe this is all just a matter of semantics and there isn't any deeper meaning. Second, maybe Apple hadn't perfected this technology and they were sharing a product that was essentially vaporware. And third, maybe AirPower was still in development, but far enough along that Apple was confident they could execute the concept in the near future, which is what I believe was the most likely scenario due to the events that followed. But before we get into that, let's explore what we do know about AirPower and why some engineers are saying it's an impossible product to make. Apple claimed AirPower would be capable of charging the iPhone, Apple Watch, and AirPod case simultaneously, something that has never been achieved before in the wireless charging market. Traditionally, a Qi charging pad contains one coil to charge one device at a time. And I should mention that it wouldn't be able to power the Apple Watch since it uses inductive charging, a completely different technology. So for Apple to make a charging mat that powers three devices using two different wireless technologies would be an amazing feat of engineering. Because not only would the mat generate a huge amount of heat, but it would require multiple overlapping charging coils to reliably power each device no matter their position on the mat. And Apple didn't stop there. They created a slick interface on the iPhone that would display the charging status of each device connected. Now, from the beginning, many people have been skeptical of how Apple managed to solve the problem of overheating and coil interference that this type of product would inevitably have. But like I said before, Apple didn't provide any details about how they solved these issues, and it could be because they hadn't. They simply thought they had a solution without thoroughly testing it to make sure it would actually work. And this appears to have been the case, because after announcing AirPower in its release date of 2018, Apple didn't share any more statements about the product. In fact, it seems they tried to make it disappear. The company removed references to AirPower from their website after the iPhone XS event, and was silent when they missed their 2018 release deadline. And this type of behavior from Apple is surprising since they're known for only announcing products when they're ready and never mentioning products still in development. I can only think of one other time when Apple broke from this custom, and that was in June 2013 with the Mac Pro sneak peek. And we all know that product didn't turn out as well as Apple had hoped. So it's worth asking why Apple decided to announce AirPower so early, because the reason why they gave a preview of the Mac Pro in 2013 was in order to appease Pro customers who had been waiting on an updated machine for years. It had been so long, in fact, some users thought Apple would discontinue their Pro computers altogether, and they began looking at alternatives. So it was definitely in Apple's best interest to assure their Pro market that a dramatic update to their most powerful computer was on the horizon. But what about AirPower? It isn't a product that many people were actually anticipating, so why wouldn't Apple just wait until it's out of development to announce it? And I honestly think it's because they wanted to mention it alongside the iPhone 8, 8 Plus, and 10, to prevent users from running out and buying third-party charging pads, leaving less customers for them. But it became clear Apple had jumped the gun, because they weren't able to solve issues with overheating, coil circuitry, and software nearly as fast as expected. Reporter Mark Gurman claimed that Apple engineers hoped to launch AirPower by June, just in time for the 2018 Worldwide Developers Conference, but this didn't happen due to persistent technical problems, so the company set a new goal of releasing the wireless charger by the end of September, likely to be announced at the iPhone XS event, which would have marked 1 year since the product's announcement. But that goal was also missed, and as 2018 came to an end, Apple didn't provide any additional information about when AirPower would debut. But a developer called Stephen Trofton Smith published a tweet on the last day of 2018 claiming he heard Apple overcame technical challenges with AirPower and was moving forward with its release. The rumor picked up steam when it was corroborated with a Hong Kong website called Charger Lab. Apparently, they received information from a credible source within Apple's supply chain that they had finally solved AirPower's manufacturing issues and it was already in production. And Charger Lab gave an update the same day, claiming that supplier Pegatron was all ready to begin mass production of AirPower on January 21st. Now, there's no way of knowing if that rumor is in fact true, but it does sound like Apple has solved most, if not all, of AirPower's technical issues, and it will be released at some point in 2019. Now, this brings me to another point of contention surrounding AirPower that has been debated since its announcement, and that is its price. Back in August 2018, a Chinese website claimed they had access to industry insiders who said AirPower would likely be priced at 1,000 Chinese yuan, or about $149 US. And this triggered a flurry of comments from users who thought that price was far too high, especially when considering AirPower's competition like Mophi, who offers a 10-watt Qi fast charger for just $60. But I don't think it's fair to make such a comparison, because if Apple does deliver on the technology they promised with AirPower, the product would be in a league of its own, and you'd essentially be getting three charging pads for the price of one, therefore making AirPower a pretty good deal at just $149. Now, I do want to mention something Phil Schiller brought up in AirPower's sneak peek that hasn't been discussed much, and it has to do with him saying,
"We hope people love it, that it encourages others to create more advanced solutions based on technology like this. We're going to be working with the Qi standards team to incorporate these benefits into the future of the standards to make wireless charging better for everyone."
Now, that's kind of a vague statement, but it certainly suggests that Apple isn't opposed to opening up their technology and patents in order to help improve all Qi chargers on the market, which is another unusual move for the company, as they typically protect their patents aggressively in order to maintain a competitive edge in the market. So I think it's safe to say that Apple has overcome the unexpected technical issues with AirPower that have caused its release to be delayed more than a year. But some people think it's too little too late, claiming AirPower was too long delayed and that iPhone users have already found wireless chargers they enjoy. But I disagree, because like I said, AirPower will be unlike any Qi charger we've seen before, similar to how AirPods were unlike any pair of wireless headphones we'd ever seen. And that new technology will bring conveniences and benefits that many users will happily pay a premium for. So based on current rumors, we'll likely see AirPower released as soon as February and as late as December 2019. I just hope Apple delivers on all the features and technology they promised during its sneak peek without compromising in order to reach mass production sooner. Now, I want to speak to my viewers who are interested in pursuing a career in computer engineering. And the best way to achieve that goal is to develop a strong foundation of skills in math, science, and problem solving. But you don't have to wait until college to start learning. There's actually a website called Brilliant that helps you learn how to solve problems by actively working on sequences of challenges instead of passively watching lectures. They also offer fun, guided daily problems in math, science, and engineering where you can discuss the solution with thousands of users. And this active approach to learning is what will really help you understand key fundamental concepts necessary to pursuing a career in technology. So to start learning with Brilliant today, go to brilliant.org/appleexplained and sign up for free. And if you're one of the first 200 people to click that link in the description, you'll receive 20% off the annual premium subscription. Okay guys, so that's the mystery behind Apple's AirPower, and if you want to vote for the next video topic, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.